It's Cody here with another video, and I'm going to do another collection video for you guys today. If you guys have not checked out my other videos where I've talked about some of my favorite channel blocks when I was a kid, I did one on Fox Kids and Nickelodeon, and today we're going to do it on Kids WB. This is my Kids WB collection. Now, some of this stuff's kind of like a repeat from Fox Kids, because a lot of stuff from Fox Kids did move over to Kids WB. Obviously, there's some stuff in my collection that are non-existent. I don't have certain TV shows from Kids WB that I really wish I can get, but I haven't had the time. I've been focusing on more stuff, like for work and, you know, stuff like that. But otherwise, I will eventually get some of the TV shows like Pinky and the Brain and, you know, stuff like that. But this is what I have. Some of it is just completely random. Like, I got a toy. I got some stuff. Like this board game over here, which I'll show you guys. But my main reason for doing this is just to kind of show you my Kids WB DVD collection. So I'm very excited to check this out. So first, we're going to look at... I honestly think it's underrated, this show, because this is the first time I've actually put this out on DVD. And it's technically season 2. So they haven't even released season 1. But it's like 39 episodes of Jackie Chan Adventures, which is a show I used to actually watch a decent amount of. I actually thought it was great. I am a huge Jackie Chan fan, so when he did this animated series, this was pretty cool. I did do an unboxing of this when I, you know, had gotten it from Mill Creek. But yeah, it's a 3-disc set, 39 episodes. I love Jackie Chan Adventures, and hopefully Mill Creek will put out the rest of the series. Next, this is obviously probably one of the best things that have been, it was on WB at the time. A lot of people may disagree. Kids had their version. Kids WB had their version. I lean more towards Kids WB when it came to the little monster genre things. So Fox had Digimon. Kids WB had Pokemon. So here I have the complete first season, or the Indigo League of Pokemon, here on Blu-ray. I picked this up a couple of years ago. Of course, I'm a huge fan of the original Pokemon. So I grew up with the craze, the original Pokemon craze. And of course, when they announced this was being released on Blu-ray, just like, okay, yeah, I'm upgrading. So this is a really nice set right here. It kind of looks like in the style of like the old VHS tapes that I used to grow up with, which is pretty cool. It only includes 52 episodes from the Indigo League. They claim the rest of the series that we remember, like when Ash fought Richie in the championship, or the Indigo League, was part of the Orange Islands, which is not true. At least I don't think it's true, because when they released the DVDs, it included those episodes. So this actually stops, like, I think, like, right when Richie is introduced, so it kind of sucks they didn't include the rest of it. And I was hoping they would put out the Orange Islands on Blu-ray, but they still haven't announced it. But yeah, you take the slip cover off, it looks like a Pokédex, which is pretty cool. And then it includes the Blu-ray here, standard Blu-ray case. Includes, like, a cookbook recipe for some sweet potato Pikachus. So, and then it includes a manga for Pokemon Adventures right there, which I remember I used to read that. But yeah, this is pretty cool. The HD is not that bad on this, but obviously it could be better, but it still looks good. I actually was able to finish this. It looks the best it's ever looked. So, of course, that's awesome. I love me some Pokemon. Let me put this back together here. So yeah, there you guys go. Pokemon Indigo League right there. And of course, to go along with that, I have the Pokemon 3 Movie Collection Steelbook Blu-ray set. These are the movies I grew up with when I was a kid. I dropped out of Pokemon, I think, around the Johto era. Not Johto League Champions, I think it was just Johto Journeys, or something like that. But I do know the third movie was based on the third season, so I grew up with both the first and second movie. And I stopped watching the movies around the one with Celebi. I think it was Pokemon Forever. So yeah, I picked these up just because of the nostalgia behind it. And of course, to go along with Pokemon, we have the complete 5-season box set of Yu-Gi-Oh! Here. Really, really nice box set. I love this, you know, this cover here. Very awesome. You got the Millennium Eye right there. And then on the side right there. And I'll kind of show you guys. This is like a really thick digipack of all 5 seasons. Well, not every season, but I'm going to try my best to show you. We got the booklet is like an episode guide here. Inside we have the discs for each individual season. I'm going to try to show it to you without ruining the case, because I've had to super glue it back because it fell apart at one point. But yeah, there's just tons of stuff on the set here, just pretty cool. I'm sorry for the glare. But yeah, and then it includes 2 movies, Bonds Beyond Time and... Oh, it includes just the 1 movie. Sorry, it includes Bonds Beyond Time. And then I picked up, separately on DVD, The Pyramid of Light, right here. They did release this on Blu-ray, and I have been eyeballing it. I do want to get it, but for now, I got the DVD right now. But yeah, that's the Yu-Gi-Oh! Movie I remember growing up with. So, there is that. So I have every episode of Yu-Gi-Oh! On DVD in this really, really snazzy box set, which I really, really like this. Look at the mirroring effect on it. That's pretty cool. And then, I've already shown these off so many times, and I promise it'll be the last time. So, Kids WB did get Batman the Animated Series at one point. So they did, I think, do the new Adventures of Batman and Robin, or the New Adventures of Batman and Superman. I can't remember what exactly it was, but I think it was season 4 when they did the Red Sky series. They put this over there. So there was that. And then, of course, they put Batman Beyond on Kids WB, which is something I grew up with. Kids WB was the brunt of most of my Batman childhood. So I remember watching the animated series on Fox Kids, but when they moved over the episodes to Kids WB and then did Batman Beyond, and then I watched the premiere of Batman Beyond Return of the Joker, that was like a good part of my childhood there. So I still had, you know, a good love for the animated series on Fox Kids, because I used to watch it on Fox Kids. Then Batman Beyond came out. And then I do believe at one point it was transferred to Cartoon Network for Toonami. Don't quote me on that. I swear I remember it being on Toonami. All right, and then the last few things here, I've shown this off. This is an original 1998 Pikachu from, you know, the original Pokemon line of toys here. Very, very cool. If you guys want to check out my review of that, it is on there, so you guys look for it. And then this is a board game that I love to death. Pokemon Master Trainer. I got this when I was a kid in 1999, almost 20 years ago, and I still love playing it. Me and my cousins used to play the hell out of this board game. I took it to Florida with me, and we didn't get around to playing it. This damn board game is a classic, okay, for us. It's memories, okay? You guys can see the back here. So it's kind of like all of the Indigo Plateau, it's pretty much Pallet Town and Ash's Travel all the way to Indigo Plateau, and you catch Pokemon along the way and stuff. So I might eventually do like an in-detail review of that board game, because it's just fun. Alright guys, autograph time. I love showing off the autographs in these videos because they are unique, and a lot of people get surprised by them when I show them off. So I do have the Kevin Conroy autograph, which I showed off in my Fox Kids video. And there's not a lot of Kids WB autographs in here, but I am going to try to show it off what I can. I do know Rob Paulsen has played some voices. I do believe Animaniacs was transferred to Kids WB at one point. So there's that. He plays Yakko Warner. Where the hell? Okay, there we go. Veronica Taylor, who voiced Ash Ketchum in the original Pokemon. That's great to have that autograph there. So, and I think that's pretty much it. Didn't have many Kids WB autographs, unfortunately. But, I have a few great ones. But yeah, guys, that is my kids' WB collection. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you guys have anything to ask, feel free to ask. I know I probably should have a little bit more than this, but I had more of a childhood with Fox Kids and Nickelodeon, and then Kids WB was just kind of like the turn of the century thing once they started doing Yu-Gi-Oh! And stuff like that. But I did watch Pokemon a lot on Kids WB when I was a kid, so, and Batman Beyond. Those were like my two favorite things to watch when I was a kid on Kids WB. But guys, thanks for watching. I'll be back with more videos soon. I'll talk to you guys later.